Hi, this is Anne with Graphic Design How To, and today I'm going to show you how to vectorize a Procreate drawing in Adobe Illustrator. And this is for a simple Procreate drawing, so pretty much black on white. If you have a lot of thin lines and a lot of detail, this is probably not the tutorial for you. All right, let's get started. Okay, I have my iPad here, and it's a good idea to start out with a large canvas. So to check that, you can come up here to the little wrench, then go to Canvas, and then Crop and Resize. And then come over here on the right to Settings. And here, you can see it's 2000 by 2000. And that is a very large canvas. So I've drawn this with the brush tool right up here. And if you're going to vectorize something, it's really best to use black on a white background in Procreate or any other colors with very high contrast, because the tool we'll be using in Illustrator, Image Trace, works best with high contrast. Okay, I'm going to open my layers panel, and you can see I have one layer here, and then I have my background color. I'm going to turn off my background color, and then I'll come up here to the little wrench. We'll choose Share, and I'll choose PNG. PNG files support transparency, and transparency is also something that works well with Image Trace in Illustrator. So I'm going to send this to my computer, and it'll come in as a PNG file. Okay, now let's go to the computer. Here's the artwork we're going to vectorize. So I'll pull this right onto my Illustrator icon, and if I click it, you can see it goes all the way out to this edge. And if we hit Command Y or Control Y, we can see this does not have vector points in it. I'll hit Command Y or Control Y to get back. I have the drawing selected, and I'll come up here to Image Trace. Now, if you're not seeing this bar, it's under Window Control right here. So I'll click Image Trace, and this is going to give us the default Image Trace options. Honestly, it looks pretty good with the default, but if we want to change it and mess with the settings, those are right up here. I'll click that to open my Image Trace panel. Here you can increase the threshold to get more black or decrease it to get more white. I'm going to leave it about what it was. You can also open Advanced and play with these sliders to get different results. Okay, now I still have it selected. I've clicked on it with my selection tool, and then I'll choose Expand right up here. Then I'll hit Y on my keyboard, which will bring me to the magic wand. I'll click the white and I'll delete it. Now, if I hit Command Y or Control Y, we can see all the little nodes, and this is vectorized at this point. So at this point, we can clean up the image a little bit. I'm going to get on my Smooth tool. This is underneath the Pencil tool. You can also hit Shift S to get there. And I'll just go over some of these areas and smooth them up a little bit. Now I'll get on my Group Selection tool, and I think I want to change this color to let's say a blue. So I'll double click on my fill. I'm going to choose a blue over here, and I like this one right here. I'll say okay. Now instead of blue, you might get a gray. So if that's happening, come up here to color, your color panel that's also under window, and you can click this little flyout and choose RGB, and that'll give you the color you want. It looks like I need to change this one to RGB too, and then I can choose a different color for my hello. And that's it. From here, I would save as an AI file. So you can go to File, Save As, and we'll just leave it as Illustrator down here, and we can rename it whatever we want. But it should end in .ai right here. So we'll save that. Now, AI files don't work on the internet, for example, so you'll also want to save a version as a PNG file or a JPEG. JPEG will give you a white background, and a PNG file will keep the transparency. So I'm just going to export as a PNG to show you what I mean. We'll choose Use Artboards and Export. I'm going to put this at 300 ppi, and here is that version with the transparent background. The JPEG would look similar, but it would have a white background. Now, if you have multiple colors in your drawing, I would want to put each color on a separate layer, then export from Procreate as a PSD file. Open it up in Photoshop, save the layers to files, and then vectorize each one separately in Adobe Illustrator. And I can make another video about that if you're interested. Just let me know in the comments section below. All right, I hope you liked this video. If you want to learn more about Procreate and other graphic design programs, just click on the subscribe button and the little bell next to it, and you'll be notified every time a new video comes out. All right, I'll see you in the next video. Thank you.